Nickname when he was in Skull and Bones was Magog, the title belonging to one of the great destructors of the end times. His position in Skull and Bones was then inherited by his son, George W. Bush.
What opened Skull and Bones, the secret society?
It's so secret we can't talk about it.
What does that mean for America? The conspiracy theorists are going to go wild.
I'm sure they are. I don't know. I haven't seen the website.
Number 322?
You both were members of Skull and Bones, a secret society at Yale. What does that tell us?
Not much, because it's a secret.
Three generations of the Bush family are admitted members of this occult organization, whose logo was the symbol of death. Perhaps now we can see why the Skull and Bones logo has become so widespread today. Proof for the satanic agenda that lies amongst some of the world's most powerful people? The rabbit hole is ever so deep.
Back in the ancient world, these Phoenician, Canaanite, Babylonian bloodstreams, which have merged to become the controlling force in the world, they worshipped a deity called Moloch or Molech. It was a deity that was an aspect of Nimrod, who keeps coming up everywhere, of course. And what they used to do is sacrifice children to Moloch or Molech. They put them through the fire. And in the Old Testament, you see prophets condemning the people for putting their children through the fire to Moloch or Molech.
Some of these rituals consist of recreations of old ceremonies that have been practiced for centuries.
And what you're looking at here, staggeringly, is a group of people, some of the most famous people in America, in long gowns. Behind them there, you see a 40-foot stone owl.
The god Moloch is usually represented as an owl that ancient pagans used to worship. Like Baphomet, Moloch was another of the manifestations of Satan. In the year 2000, independent journalist Alex Jones had uncovered one of the darkest secrets being hidden in the world today. In Southern California lies the headquarters of secret society, the Bohemian Club, known as the Bohemian Grove. Externally, it is portrayed as a nature retreat where members come yearly to relax. However, when Alex Jones infiltrated this retreat with a hidden camera, he uncovered what was really going on. It is important to note that most United States presidents, as well as banking CEOs and other influential figures worldwide, attend this retreat every year. In this image taken in 1967, we see both presidents, Ronald Reagan and Richard Nixon, attending this retreat before either of them entered the presidency. But what is it that attracts members to this retreat every year? One ritual that members admit to attending is called the cremation of care, a ritual that is meant to symbolize the removal of care from the minds of the members, a way to relax from the responsibilities of the world, if just for one night. But what goes on in this ritual? What is the method that these people use to relax? following footage that was filmed in Bohemian Grove by Alex Jones is not for the weak-hearted. But it is essential to understand how deep the link is between our leaders and Satan. How dedicated they are to elevating his status.
Administrations. The Bohemian Grove, when you joined as a Clinton advisor, the Republicans were criticizing you, oh, what about Bohemian Grove? And then you countered them by saying, hey, I don't run around in the woods naked. What did that mean?
Here is the before mentioned Washington Times article where he said, I didn't run around naked like they do.
I don't know what quote you're referring to. I'm not aware of any quote like that. I'm a happy member of the Bohemian Grove. I like the folks who come there, and it's really inappropriate for me to talk about the group beyond them. Thank you.
Have you been there for the ceremony with the cremation of care?
Frankly, I don't think that's something I need to talk to you about.
Really?
That's right.
Well, I'm Alex Jones, and I snuck in there in 2000. I'm the guy that blew it wide open.
I got the video. It's been on national TV.
Well, I disrespect you for that. That was not a gentlemanly thing.
But what about the ritual? Is the ritual genuinely?
Thank you and goodbye.
The ritual?
That's none of your damn business.
Oh, look how strangely he behaved when we brought it up. Why is he acting so secretive? Why did he get so angry when he discovered that we'd snuck in? See, they take it very, very seriously. This is one of the hallmarks of the occult and secret societies. The word occult means secret. Secrecy is part of their religion. They revel in it. And when it's violated, they become extremely angry.
One might wonder, understandably, why the people that run the banking, political, economic system, and the media in America should be dressed in long robes, doing a ceremony to a 40-foot stone owl. I think we should be told ourselves. So what's it all about when they're sacrificing children, the deity in the modern world today that they use to sacrifice them to a Washington street map? I found this around the Congress building, this Congress building in the middle. And just by drawing in red pen on the roads within the Congress building complex, very obviously an owl appears. When you look at the next shot, this is not being doctored by me in any way with a red pen. This is just a shot directly from a Washington street plan. And there you see around the Congress building the owl, Moloch, deity going back to Babylon and this whole story I've been talking about. And he's actually sitting on top of a pyramid. A pyramid and all-seeing owl, just like the pyramid and all-seeing eye. Because the owl and the eye symbolize the same thing, this force which controls the world through these bloodlines.
Are you beginning to see how deep this tunnel goes? The armies of Shaitan have been working and planning for years. Their symbol has always been right in front of our eyes.
The greatest trick the devil ever pulled was convincing the world he didn't exist.